Welcome to the history session. Once again, today we will have one more topic of history. I am your Dr. R.V. Chittukuppi, who will discuss on the World Heritage UNESCO Historical Sites of India. So UNESCO has recognized certain historical monuments as the World Heritage. So in India, here, which are those monuments? Why they have been given the UNESCO World Heritage status? So this we are going to here mainly discuss today in our here session. Usually students, in your examination, from general study point of view, you can here expect the question from the World Heritage Sites of India. So the questions will appear at all the levels of the examinations, whether it is at a state level examination or here the union service examinations. So you can expect one question on World Heritage. So recently a lot of importance is given to this topic, art and architecture. So that makes this topic important from your competitive examinations. So here, today, as far as mainly the UNESCO list is concerned, in India, totally we have 39 World Heritage Sites, which includes here the historical sites, the mountain railways, and the natural sites. So it is here together. However, in this session, we will be here confining our discussion only to the historical monuments which have been listed in the UNESCO World Heritage. So here we will commence this mainly the session here state wise I will be discussing which are the World Heritage sites, and we are going to start it from south to north we are going to study. So the first state and the World Heritage Sites, historical sites located in that mainly the state. So the first here state is Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu has two important historical World Heritage Sites. One is mainly the monuments at Mahabalipuram. The monuments which are located at Mahabalipuram. Mahabalipuram is one of the mainly the site of the Pallava art. Pallavas who ruled in Tamil Nadu region. So they ruled from 7th century AD to the 9th century AD. So we have these monuments belonging to the Pallavas at Mahabalipuram. Mahabalipuram is also known as Mamallapuram and called as the cradle of Dravid architecture. Some of the important monuments at this place are the cave temples like Varaha Cave Mantapa, the Tiger Mantapa or the Tiger Cave here, then the monolithic temples called as the Rathas. Out of that, the most famous Rathas are the Pancha Pandava Rathas and the structural temple like the Shore Temple. So these monuments here are clubbed and they are given World Heritage here, mainly the recognition. And also Mahabalipuram has one of the biggest bas relief called as the Descent of Ganges or Arjuna's Tapas. So this here is in Tamil Nadu, what we have got, the monuments belonging to the Pallava dynasty. The second one is the group of Chola temples. The Cholas here who ruled from 9th century to 13th century in Tamil Nadu region, here they mainly built many temples. Out of that, three temples have been grouped in this as the World Heritage, like the Brahadeshwara Temple of Tanjavur, the Shiva Temple of Gangaikonda Cholapuram, the Airavateshwara Temple of Dharasuram. These three Chola temples have been included as the World Heritage UNESCO sites. Out of that, one question in your examination had appeared here long back in the UPSC examination. This question had been asked. So the question was here, it was in 2010, which World Heritage site completed 1000 years? So the World Heritage site which completed here 1000 years, 2010, and to mark the occasion, the Indian Postal Department brought out a stamp having the figure of that World Heritage. So this was the question that had appeared in the examination, and the answer to this is the Brahadeshwara Temple at Tanjavur, which was built in 1010 by the great ruler of the Cholas, Rajaraja I. So this was the question how they had asked in the examination. So this is here one example I just gave you how the questions will appear here. The Tanjavur Brahadeshwara Temple. So this group is mainly comprising three temples of the Chola period. So the here Pallavas and the Cholas, the two important rulers of Tamil Nadu, have contributed to the growth of the South Indian Hindu architecture called as the Dravida architecture, and the examples of these two are at Mahabalipuram and Chandavur, Dharasuram and Gangaikonda Cholapuram. So this has been mainly here in the World Heritage List. Followed by this, coming to Karnataka. In Karnataka, we have two historical World Heritage sites. One is the Pattadakal group of temples belonging to early Chalukyas, or also they were called as the Chalukyas of Vatapi or Badami, who ruled from 6th century AD to the middle of 8th century AD. And Pattadakal was one of their important art center, where we have the temples like Virupaksha Temple, Mallikarjuna Temple. Earlier, these two temples were known as Lokeshwara Temple and Trilokeshwara Temple. Kashi Vishwanatha Temple, Galaganatha group of the temples has been grouped and recognized as a World Heritage Site. The reason for this is the uniqueness of the blending of Dravida and Nagara styles, which we call it as the Vesara style. So Pattadakal is the best example for the Vesara architecture. And another site in Karnataka is the monuments at Hampi. The monuments at Hampi belonging to Vijayanagara period, which ruled from 14th century to 17th century. The monuments of Hampi here have been considered in the UNESCO World Heritage Site. So we have the temples like the Vijayavitthala Temple, the Hazar Rama Temple, Pattabhi Rama Temple, Kodanda Rama Temple, Virupaksha Temple, along with this monolithic here Hindu god sculptures or the idols like Ugra Narasimha and Ganesha. The Indo-Islamic monuments like Lotus Mahal, the Elephant Stable, Queen's Bath, they are all grouped here together and they have been here given the World Heritage. So the reason is you can see the merging of the here Hindu architecture as well as the Islamic architecture at this place. So that is the uniqueness here which gets the World Heritage Site. That is the criteria for the recognition there. And a very interesting aspect here, all of you know this. Today, in our mainly the new currency which has been introduced after the demonetization, here on 50 rupees note, we have got one World Heritage here, the mainly picture. That is the stone chariot of Hampi, which is in Vijayavitthala Temple. That is, we have it in the 50 rupees note. So like this, two monuments here, mainly historical monuments in Karnataka. Coming to Goa. In Goa, 7 Portuguese churches are here merged and declared as World Heritage. The Portuguese churches are clubbed and they have been declared as World Heritage. And out of these, here the most important church is Bom Jesus Basilica, where we can still see the body of Father Xavier's here conserved, protected, who had come to India in the 16th century, and his body is preserved in this church. So apart from this, the other 6 churches of the Portuguese period are clubbed in the World Heritage. So in Goa, we have got this, mainly the one site. Moving to Maharashtra, this can be a question. In India, if you look at the most of the historical World Heritage UNESCO sites are located in Maharashtra. And in Maharashtra, we have got 5 World Heritage sites. The first one being the Ajanta Caves. Ajanta Caves, here they are Buddhist caves. 25 caves are the Viharas and 4 caves are Chaityas, totally 29 caves. And these caves have become famous for their paintings, which cover the period between 2nd century to 7th century. Most of the paintings belongs to Guptas and the Vakatika period. The paintings are of Buddhist nature, the Buddhist paintings, which can be seen today here in the cave number 1 and 2, 9 and 10, 16 and 17. These 6 caves have well-preserved paintings of Buddhism. They deal with here the incidents related to the life of Buddha and the Jataka stories. And this is the first World Heritage Site recognized by UNESCO, that is in 1983. From then onwards, the sites have been recognized. So the first site to be recognized is Ajanta cave paintings, or we call it as Ajanta frescoes. The next one is the Ellora caves. So in Ellora, we have got 34 caves. The first 12 caves, 1 to 12, they are Buddhist caves and they belong to Shatavahana period. 13 to 29 are Hindu caves belonging to Rashtrakuta period. And 30 to 34 are the Jaina caves. So these 34 caves what we have got at Ellora, they have been here declared as the UNESCO site. And out of these 34 caves, the most important cave is the 16th cave, where we have got the famous monolithic temple, the Kailasanatha temple, built under the Rashtrakuta king Krishna the First, 8th century AD. So this here in Ellora, we have got this, mainly the Kailasanatha temple, one of the here well-known temple. As Percy Brown has said, this temple as one of the wonders of the world. This is one of the sites we have got. Moving to a small island near Mumbai in Arabian Sea, the Elephanta Island, earlier known as Gauravapura. But today, as Portuguese have renamed it as Elephanta, the Elephanta Caves, known for the famous the Trimurti Cave. The Trimurti Cave is famous, which has been included in the their UNESCO list. The Elephanta Caves, it's a small island. And then we have got at Mumbai, the British period, the Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus, which is an example of the Gothic architecture here during the British period. It is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Earlier it was known as Victoria Terminus, now it is known as Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus, where we have got the head office of the railways. That is here a UNESCO site, the fourth one. And the fifth one is the Victorian Gothic building complex in Mumbai, which is declared as the UNESCO World Heritage Site. Totally in Maharashtra, we have got five historical World Heritage Sites. And out of this, another mainly aspect which can be asked in the examination. Here, as you have seen, here the new 20 rupees note. The 20 rupees note is having here the picture of the Kailasanatha temple of Ellora. So most of our new here currencies, what we have got on that, we have got the World Heritage pictures. World Heritage Sites pictures are there. So Kailasanatha is on rupees 20 there. From Maharashtra, we move to Gujarat. In Gujarat, we have got three important UNESCO sites. Mainly, 15th and 16th century Hindu and Islamic monuments at Pavagadh and Champaner. They are here the regional dynasties. The regional dynasties have developed this Pavagadh and Champaner, 15th and 16th century monuments. So both the places together are clubbed as a UNESCO site. We have Hindu and Islamic here buildings. Then at a place called Patan, the seven-storied stepped well, popularly known as Rani Ka Wa, the step well, seven stories, beautifully carved with a lot of sculptures of Ramayana, Mahabharata and the Puranas. So this has been here mainly put in the UNESCO site. And also you can see the picture of this Rani Ka Wa today on our new 100 rupees note. On the new 100 rupees note, you have got this Rani Ka Wa. That is at a place called Patan in Gujarat. This is a UNESCO site what we have got in Gujarat. So the Pavagadh and Champaner and this here Rani Ka Wa. And the third one is the first cultural city of India to be declared in the UNESCO list is Ahmedabad. Ahmedabad in Gujarat has been declared as the cultural city and it is a UNESCO here mainly site. So in Gujarat, we have got three sites. From Gujarat, we move to Rajasthan. In Rajasthan, again, we have three sites, three important sites. Six forts of the Rajputs are merged and they have been here declared as one site. Six forts. Out of that, the most famous are Chittorgarh Fort, Amer Fort, Jaisalmer Fort, Kumbalgarh Fort. So the here mainly Rajput forts, they are clubbed as one UNESCO site. That is the one. Then we have at Jaipur, the Jantar Mantar, the sun clock, the sun dial. So that is here an observatory which was built by Savai Jai Singh. It belongs to here mainly the 17th and 18th century. So that has been here recognized today, the Jantar Mantar of Jaipur. And the old city of Jaipur called as the Pink City, here that has been listed as another UNESCO World Heritage Site. So totally in Rajasthan, you have got three important sites. Three important sites are there in Rajasthan.